Starship is about to launch, featuring major upgrades and a strong step into the future. At the heart of these changes is Launchpad B, a site that has been built from the ground up over the past year. Now that construction is nearing completion, the final pieces are being assembled, meaning operations may soon begin. What has changed at this crucial launch site? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. Launchpad A has been crucial to Starship's development. From the first model through its ninth launch, this launch site has been crucial to nearly every key moment in the program. Despite its importance, Launchpad A was not designed for the long-term future of Starship. The infrastructure is still functional, but it needs better design to be ready for the next phase, especially as more powerful and complex versions of Starship are being developed. That's why SpaceX has invested in building a second launch pad called Launchpad B. Designed from the ground up with future needs in mind, the site features significant upgrades to all major systems. The Orbital Launch Pad, or OLM, has undergone significant structural improvements. The water containment system has been upgraded to better handle the intense heat and noise during liftoff. After more than a year of consistent progress, the B pad is now nearing completion. The latest significant change is the introduction of the booster quick disconnect hood. This part helps protect the connections used to refuel the booster. On the 17th of this month, the hood was brought to the launch site. Its large size and new design caught everyone's attention. The new BQD hood is much larger than the one currently used on the A pad. This hood will likely assist the new Starship V3 models coming soon. These new vehicles will require more fuel and have more complex electrical and data connections. All of this will need to be handled by a new interface. The hood's shape differs from previous designs. Instead of being curved to fit the OLM, it is now rectangular. This means it will likely be placed on a separate QD gantry rather than built directly into the OLM. This approach should simplify changes and upgrades. The hood also has large rectangular openings at both ends. These openings facilitate the installation of internal systems such as high-flow fuel lines, retractable QD panels, and thermal shields. One of these sections shows several small ports that could be used for additional systems related to fueling or control. However, the hood itself is not fully assembled. Several components, such as connector plates, shields, and access doors, still need to be added. The absence of latches or handles suggests these components are still in production or will be added later.
When put together, the whole cover will keep the booster's fuel and electronic systems safe from debris and shockwaves during the launch. This is very important because of what we learned from past missions like Flight 3. Besides the QD system, other improvements have been happening at Pad B. Several manifolds have been attached to the sides of the OLM. These help connect the storage tanks on the ground to the launch pad for propellant and water. These new plumbing connections show that the fueling systems are almost finished. The clamp arms that keep the booster in place before it's ignited have been improved. The Pad B OLM now has 20 clamps, up from the 4 that were there when it was first spotted at the Sanchez site. By early July, all 20 were put in place. These arms look smaller and possibly stronger than the ones before, which suggests they are made to handle the greater forces expected from Starship V3. Every system added to Pad B is designed to be reliable, easy to expand, and tough enough to handle the environment. Because they face tough conditions like salty air, rain, and high heat, their setup and testing need to be very precise. The site is very busy every day, showing that it is almost ready to move from building to testing. When will Pad B be ready? It looks like construction might be finished by the end of this month based on the recent updates. The first tests will probably include checking the pipe pressure, how the valves respond, and if the system is connected properly. After these dry runs, we will have full rehearsals and static fire tests. This process might take 1 to 2 months, depending on how smoothly things go. To check that these systems work, SpaceX will need something to test. B-15, which has been kept in reserve, is a good option for early checks. Another option is to use Test Tank 17 to mimic a V3-class Starship. This tank has been sitting in the test cage for months and might soon be moved to the pad for initial assembly. Once these steps are completed, Pad B will be ready for its first launch. Although many thought SpaceX would launch the strong Starship V3 right away, they may choose to go a slower route. Flight 11 might use the latest version of the V1 and V2 equipment. It could be a final test of the launch pad under familiar conditions before moving to the more advanced V3 design. Flight 10 is expected to take off in early August. If it goes well, Flight 11 could take off in 1 or 2 months. This timeline matches Pad B's planned activation schedule, indicating that it might be used for the first time this fall. After over a year of planning, building, and engineering, Pad B is ready to change the future of Starship. This new facility has better clamps, improved fuel connections, stronger launch supports, and a modular design for easy integration. It's not just a backup, it's a significant upgrade. It's the plan for SpaceX's next steps.
Will it support Starship V3 from the start, or will SpaceX conduct one final mission with older equipment first? We'll have to wait and see. It's clear that Pad B is shaping up to be the center of attention. As launch approaches, everyone in the spaceflight community will be watching closely. Yes, Pad B will be crucial to the next phase of the Starship program. Pad A did a great job during the V1 and V2 development phases, but Starship V3 needs stronger and better infrastructure. Pad B fills that need. It's specifically designed for its size, power, and future complexity. With the new Raptor 3 engines generating more power and heat, a stronger and better support system is crucial. Pad B meets this need perfectly. One of the biggest improvements is the new orbital launch stand. The tall, skinny structure on Pad A has been replaced with a stronger, smaller platform. This new design can handle more stress and makes upgrades easier. Most importantly, the quick disconnect arm that provided fuel and power to the rocket before launch is no longer connected to the OLM. Now, these arms function as separate systems, offering greater flexibility and safer operation. One of the most important parts of Pad B is its fire bucket system. Pad B uses a dual fire bucket design instead of steel plates cooled by high-pressure water jets. These steel plates had begun to show problems after a few uses. This system diverts heat and pressure away from critical parts, keeping the pad structure intact even when the Raptor 3 rocket launches with high power. Its effectiveness had been demonstrated at the Massey test site, and Pad B is building on this idea by providing a solution that can easily handle multiple high-intensity launches. This major infrastructure upgrade represents a change in approach. SpaceX isn't just preparing for even bigger rockets, they're preparing for more rockets. Pad B is designed to be durable and reusable, allowing for much faster speeds than before. Pad A is still functional, but it's beginning to discolor and show signs of heat damage. SpaceX plans to improve Pad A using what they've learned from Pad B. They'll replace the old structure and steel plates with new fire buckets and systems. This likely means that Pad A will cease to function, leaving Pad B to become the primary pad at Starbase. The impact of Pad B is beginning to grow. At Cape Canaveral's Launch Complex 39A, SpaceX has ditched the old six-legged design and replaced it with a newer setup similar to Pad B. Future systems at SLC 37 and other Starbase locations are expected to do the same. This isn't just a change, it's a whole new level. Pad B is now the template for all future Starship launch setups, and much remains to be done. Three major deployment plans are planned.